Video lecture of marketing research, semester 5, module 1. In today's topic, we are continuing with where we left off in our previous lecture, that is classification of research. In our previous lecture, we have covered purpose of doing research. So we have also completed exploratory research, descriptive research, and explanatory or causal research. In today's lecture, we are going to study the classification based upon uses of research. Under uses of research, research is classified into two types. The first one, basic research, and the second one, applied research. Basic research is also known as fundamental research or pure research. So let's begin. So based upon the criteria, that is based upon where you are going to use the research or how you are going to use the research findings, research can be further divided into two types. The first one we have seen is applied research, and the second one is fundamental or basic research. Some researchers focus on using research to advance general knowledge, whereas some others use it to solve some certain problems that are there in hand. For example, when Newton discovered the law of gravitation, he did not have any specific problem at hand. He discovered it, he worked on it, and his research has increased the knowledge pool of human beings. He has increased the knowledge pool of the entire scientific society. Hence, his research is classified as basic research or pure research. Whereas if you are doing a research when you have a particular problem at hand, then this research, what you are conducting, will be known as applied research, because you are going to apply the findings of your research to a particular area of your organization. So basically, basic research, it is also known as pure or fundamental research. What is it? It is an investigation and analysis focused on better or fuller understanding of a subject. So when you have a thirst to understand a subject, just not because you have a problem at hand, just you want to know something more about the problem, then you do a basic research. So it is basically investigation and analysis which is focused on better understanding of a particular subject, phenomenon, or basic law of nature, instead of a specific practical application of the results. So there is no specific practical application. This is not there in basic research. What you have is, you are doing it just to increase the knowledge pool. You are just doing the research to have better understanding about the subject or phenomenon or basic law of science. What Newton did, what I had said earlier, that is the law of gravitation, is definitely a basic research because it has increased the knowledge. The findings of basic research can be used in applied research later on, but whatever were his findings, why a stone falls on earth when we throw it up, this is basically a basic research. So whatever he did was a basic. It does not directly involve the situation to a particular pragmatic problem. There is no problem at hand. You will not find a solution to any particular problem at hand. But what happens is, you increase the knowledge pool. The knowledge gained by the findings of basic research can be used by others. And it is just for example, this Newton's example which I had given is available in public domain, and others can use this to do their own research. You can verify the acceptability of a given theory also. So when you're doing a verification whether a given theory which is there, whether it is right or wrong, whether you are going to support it or you are going to go against a particular theory based upon your research, and such kind of research when you're doing, that is nothing but a basic research. An applied research, on the other hand, has a particular problem at hand. So when research is done with the intention of applying, there is an intention of applying the results of findings to solve the particular problem which is there currently in your organization. So when you're doing such kind of a research, this research is known as applied research. When is it conducted? It is generally conducted when a decision must be made about a specific real-time problem. For example, if the production department faces a problem that you are not producing, that means there is a lot of rejection, you are not producing that quality of required quality of the finished goods, and there are a lot of rejections, then if you are gonna do a research on why there are so many rejections from your quality control, then this is an applied research, because you are gonna apply the findings of your research in your organization. So that is why it becomes an applied research. Now, applied research is normally used in organizations, and we have various types of applied research. The first one is action research. Now, what is this action research? Action research allows practitioners to address those concerns that are closest to them. For example, if a teacher in a school finds that the students are making too much of noise in a class, and she conducts a research maybe by observation or some other way, why students are doing so much of noise in her class, then this is an action research. She is doing, she is trying to address a problem that is very close to her. In this, researcher wants to improve the way they address issues and solve problems. In larger organization, generally it is guided by professional researchers. Action research is a type of applied research that is set on providing practical solutions to specific business problems by pointing the business in the right directions. Typically, action research is a process of reflective inquiry that is limited to specific contexts and situations in nature. So basically, action research is nothing but action, that is, you're taking an action by way of research. So action research is action and research. Now, there is a cycle, that is, just like in quality control you have a PDCA cycle, here also you have similar kind of a cycle: act, review, act, review, kind of a cycle that generally happens. So you act, then based upon your actions you review your situations, how those actions have happened, then again you take a particular actions to better the situation, then you review the situation, then again you act on the situation, and so on. This cycle goes on until you achieve your results. The second type of action research is R&D. R&D, this name you might have come across many times in newspaper. Generally, in today's world, we see a lot of bigger organizations having an R&D department. What is this R&D? R&D stands for research and development. Generally, when you are innovating or you are coming up with a new product, then this is carried out by your R&D department, that is research and development wing, or the research and development department. So your research for development of new products, generally when new products or innovative products are being launched, this is taken care by your research and development department. So whenever new or innovative products are done, that is nothing but they are done subject of research and development. The third type of action research that we are discussing is impact assessment research. As the name suggests, impact assessment research. So suppose if you are taken a particular decision, now this decision will have certain impact. Now if you want to assess the impact of your decisions that you have taken, then that is impact means results of the decision you have taken, then this research, when you are doing this, is known as impact assessment research. Its main purpose is to estimate the likely consequences in advance. Likely consequences means in advance only. Suppose if I take a particular decision, what are the consequences out of it, of a planned change? So this research, when you are conducting, this is nothing but an impact assessment research. Before taking a decision, you are doing a research. If I take a particular decision, what will be the impact on a particular thing. Such an assessment is used for generally planning purpose and making choices among the alternatives. You have many alternatives. In management concepts, you might have learned one step is choosing among the alternatives. You have few alternatives. Out of that, you have to make the best choice. Now, to know which is the best choice, you have to think, if I take option one, what will be the impact on of this? Think of this. Do a research. If I use option B or alternative B, then what will be the impact out of because of using that option? Do a research on that. If I use the last option, that is option C, what will be the impact by using option C? When you're doing this kind of a research, this is known as impact assessment research. For example, Kaiga project, which is there in Karwar, Karnataka. So when this project was being launched, the impact of Kaiga project on the environment, especially the Western Ghats, was studied in advance, and then the project was set. So this research is nothing but an impact assessment research. What will be the result of if I take a particular decision or if I start a particular project? So this research is nothing but impact assessment research. The next type of research that we are studying is evaluation research. Now, what is this evaluation research? It addresses the question, did it work? Now, I have taken a particular decision, I have chosen a particular alternative, and now after using an alternative, whether it has worked in the way it was intended to work. The process of establishing value judgment based on evidence, that is very important, based upon evidence. You just cannot be subjective on it. There should be an objective evidence about the achievement of the goals, whether it has done what is it was intended to do. So suppose if you have taken a particular decision, or you have done a particular program, you have come up with a policy or something else in your organization, and you had come up with that policy with a particular intention that this will be the impact of it, whether it has achieved that goal or no. When you're doing that research, this is nothing but evaluation research. The two types of evaluation research. Now, there are two types of evaluation research, formative and summative research. This is in depth, so I'll just go through this. Formative evaluation is built-in monitoring or continuous feedback on a program used for program management, whereas summative evaluation looks at final program outcomes. Both are usually necessary. So what happens is, in formative evaluation, you get continuous feedback during and after the decision was done. So continuous kind of monitoring happens, whereas in summative, no, there is no such continue or intermittent evaluation that is done. In summative evaluation, what is done is, at the end, at a particular time, what is the evaluation or how will you evaluate your decision, that is the final outcome of your project or program, only that is counted. So these are some of the types of action research. So now moving towards some of the examples of applied research, we'll just go through what can be some of the examples of applied research. Now suppose the UGC, that is University Grants Commission, conducts research on should faculty be promoted on the basis of seniority or on merit or educational base. So if this is the criteria, it is an applied research, because they based upon the research findings, they are going to use this findings of the research for a particular problem. What was the problem? How should faculty be promoted? So if this is the problem, they are going to come up with a solution by doing this research. The next, should Airtel introduce a new postpaid package? Suppose if you are a senior manager in Airtel, then you might come across with this problem that maybe your customer base is going down because of increasing competition. If that is happening, then you should come up with a solution. To come up with a solution, you have to conduct a particular research. That research may be that whether a new postpaid package is needed for Airtel. So if this is there, how it should be there? So that is the later one. But whatever this research you are conducting, that is, should Airtel introduce a new postpaid package? Based upon the findings of the research, you are going to apply it in your organization. So that is why it is an applied research. A product is not selling in the market to check the reasons and rectifying them. Again, applied research, you are going to apply the findings of the research. Then RBI, for example, it is conducting research on how to control inflation in a country, that is in our country. So the, again, applied research, the findings of this research will be used into policies by the RBI. OPEC, oil and petroleum exporting countries, OPEC, conducting research on how to control the prices of petrol around the globe. OPEC generally sets the price for oil, crude oil, around the globe. So OPEC is suppose if it is conducting research on how to control the prices of oil and petrol around the world, this is again an applied research, because based upon the findings, they are going to utilize the findings and in their organizations. Basic research examples. Now coming back to basic research example, basic research, I'll tell you, basic research is just done not because there is a problem, just done to increase the knowledge pool of the society, to gain better understanding of a subject. So what can be an example of basic research? Is executive success, that is employee success you can say, correlated with high need for achievement? So if is there, there are two things here. High need for achievement, there is a high need, if the employee has or a person has high need of achievement and the success that he achieves, are they correlated or what? So if we want to do this kind of research, then it is a basic research. Why? Because this we are not going to apply in your organization. This is just, it will increase the knowledge pool of the society. Are members of highly cohesive work groups more satisfied than members of less cohesive work group? Cohesive means who mingle together very much. They are very closely bound together by certain maybe social groups. So are members of highly cohesive work groups in an organization more satisfied? Are they more satisfied than those people who are less cohesive work groups? Do consumers experience cognitive dissonance in low involvement situations? We have seen this in marketing, this management, that this, there are four types of decision, where high involvement is there, low involvement is there. Then we also know what is dissonance. So cognitive dissonance, do they experience in low involvement situation? Generally in low involvement situations, the cognitive decision is considered that it is not there. But do they experience, or if they experience, what is the amount of cognitive dissonance that they are experiencing? So if we are doing this research, again it is a basic research. Then if you want to know the causes of inflation in India, it is a basic research. Does solar flares intensity affect monsoon in India? So if you want to do a study like if there are solar flares, that is the intensity, you can say the winds that are coming out of this fire that is coming out of the sun, that is solar flares basically. So the intensity will sometimes increase, sometimes go down. So if the intensity is more during summer, do they affect the monsoon in India? So if this is there, you cannot change the intensity of solar flares, but you can have a better understanding about the subject, you can be well prepared. So it will increase the knowledge pool only. So does solar flares intensity affect monsoon in India? That is again a basic research. Now lastly, what is the difference between applied and fundamental research? Applied or fundamental research. So applied research is aimed at solving current problem that is there in hand with the organization, whereas fundamental research has more general objective of generating knowledge and understanding of the organization problems. So these are, this is the main difference between applied and fundamental research. In applied research, basically what we are doing is we are going to apply the findings of the research in the organizations. So it is based upon, or it is aimed to solve a particular problem that is there in hand in the organization. If you have a problem in the organization and you want to solve it, you'll go for applied research, because the findings of that research you are going to apply in the organization. But in fundamental research also, which is also known as basic research or pure research, what is going to happen is You are doing it just to gain better understanding of the subject. You are gonna do this to increase the knowledge pool of the society in general and understanding the organizational problems. So this is what you are gonna use fundamental research for. So for today's lecture, we'll stop here. In the next lecture, we shall begin with the next mode of classification. Thank you for watching.